guys, now it's time for a new project. Since we moved to this house and we have this really small shop, I got this air compressor. It's a 220 volt 50 liter tank, and I have had this all the time I lived this, but I thought this was a good one because of the twin cylinders and it's quite big and so, but it's totally useless, and it has so very low efficiency so that you can't use hardly any tool at all. So now I have ordered a low noise compressor from eBay. I'm getting it either day now, and that one also has a 50 liter tank, and it has four blocks. Well, I actually don't really know how they work, but it should have a lot more capacity than this useless piece of junk, as you may call it, with no bad conscience at all. So the project now is to make this to an accumulator tank to the new compressor, so I get 100 liters of fresh hard packed air for my tools, because I'm dying to use my grinding tools. I really love the small straight or an angle pneumatic grinding tools. I use them at the work all the time and I really love them. So I hope I'm finally going to use them again. So what I'm going to do is strip the engine and all the engine package off, strip away all this, which is broken and heavily modified by me. But I'm going to use the regulator and the safety valve, and I think here I'm going to put in the new inlet from the new compressor and use this as the outlet. So let's begin. Now I've taken off everything that I don't want no more. I'm maybe going to cut away the handle, but these mounts, maybe I save them, and also the wheels, because I don't really know how I'm going to place the new compressor, because it's roughly the same size and the space I have for them is here. So maybe I stack them on top of each other or next to each other, I don't know. So I'm keeping the wheels and these mounts for now, and but the handle I'm going to cut, because I can't think of any use of that now. So but anyways, what I have to do now is to get the inlet, which is going to be here, and this one is going off because it isn't no good. Then I'm going to found this hydraulic coupler in old corner here, so I'm going to use this one. This is the closest I got, because the thread is the same there. And then I'm going to use a male pneumatic coupler, So I have to drill out and thread this hole and take off the old threads on the outside to clean it up a little. So that I must do, and I must make a plug here and plug this one, because there is no use for this one now. So a plug there and a thread there. So let's go and do some lathing. The inlet is red there. It turned out really good. So now it's just time to make the plug for where the electric pressure switch was mounted before. So I have to plug this one. I mounted a female coupler as a plug here, so I also, if I want, get the bonus outlet. So that turned out really good, I think. Now I'm going to cut off the handle and clean it up. Then it's just have to wait for the new compressor so I can test it out and see how I place them in the shop. Finally, my new compressor is here. The first one they sent got lost in Holland on its way here, but the seller just resended a new one immediately, so I got this one. And so I'm very positive with the seller. And please hit me up in the comments if you want a link to where I bought it. My very scientific way of doing this is first have a freshly filled compressor without the ACT tank, and use my favorite angle grinder and measure the time it takes before I empty the pressure in the compressor so it starts to load again. Then I'm going to connect my ACT tank and do the same thing again and measure it, and then we see how much more time we get with the tank. Let's do this. Yeah, let's start this test. Yeah, ready for take two, now with the ACT tank. Seconds. I was a little slow on the stop there, but almost triple the capacity. Not bad. Yeah, it's safe to say that the accumulator tank is a big improvement. Almost three times the amount of time before the compressor starts to build up new. Well, before the pressure drops so much that it has to start go again. The one thing is it's I set it up so that the compressor is at 8 bar and the accumulator tank is at about 6.5 bar, because I think that is plenty of pressure for the grinding tools and the tools I need and use in the shop. So that makes it a bit easier on the compressor. I'm maybe going to experiment dropping the pressure to about 7 or 6.5 bars on this one too, so it doesn't have to build that high pressure, because the engines get quite hot, I notice now. But all in all, super happy with the new compressor. It's so quiet and nice, and super happy with the ACT tank, so I can use my grinding tools again. Yeah, thank you for watching, and if please leave any questions, as I said earlier, in the comments. I try to answer them. Bye bye.